Adam Schiff. He's the top Democrat on the Intelligence Committee in the House. Congressman Schiff, thank you for being here tonight. I really appreciate your time.
You bet. Thank you, Rachel.
I described this as strange news, and I will admit to being a little bit baffled by this. Can I just ask if this is something that you were surprised to learn tonight? Did you know this was happening? And can you help me understand what it means?
Well, during the recess, we were informed that the majority wanted to send subpoenas to the DOJ and FBI requesting these documents, which I think perplexed us because we hadn't even made a voluntary request by letter for the information. We have a committee practice. We don't subpoena parties unless they turn down our request for information, which the FBI and DOJ really hadn't done. So we opposed it. We thought it wasn't warranted. They told us they were going to do it anyway. And this also stood in stark contrast to a different situation where we had requested twice in writing documents from the White House, any tapes or memoranda reflecting conversations between the President and Director Comey. And the White House basically sent us misleading and incomplete replies. And there, we really should subpoena the White House, but they have not been willing. So I was concerned about both the disparate treatment here, but also really trying to antagonize the FBI and DOJ, trying to provoke a conflict, potentially special counsel. I think, Rachel, basically what's going on here is, you know, something that I saw back in my days as a prosecutor. Sometimes the defense opts for a strategy of trying to put the government on trial. And here I think there's a hope that if they can impeach Christopher Steele and they can impeach the FBI and DOJ, maybe they can impeach the whole Russia investigation. But that's not our purpose. It's really at cross purposes. We ought to be trying to figure out how much is accurate within what Mr. Steele reported, not trying to discredit him for some reason.
Are they, I mean, I don't want to ask you to put words in their mouth, and I know that you can really only speak for yourself, and you're very careful about that in terms of dealing with your colleagues on the committee, but I don't really understand the point that they're trying to make. Are they trying to create a counter-narrative in which the existence of the dossier is itself a scandal, that that's the Russia scandal, that the dossier itself is the original sin, and that therefore the FBI is participating in some sort of Russian plot when it comes to the dossier?
You know, I honestly don't really understand what they hope to accomplish with this. Maybe they can discredit Mr. Steele, although he's held in very high regard within the intelligence community. Maybe they want to discredit people in the FBI or the Department of Justice. But what's to be gained about that? It doesn't undercut the fact that Russia hacked our election institutions and tried to influence the outcome of our election. It's only going to impede our ability to get at the facts. So I don't really understand what they hope to accomplish from this, but I am disturbed at this quite evident double standard of subpoenaing agents for public effect. I think that's really what was designed here, rather than investigatory purpose. And where we really do have a need for subpoenas, as in the case when the White House refuses two voluntary requests to comply, we can't get their acquiescence in a subpoena. So it is a worrying trend.
And I'm not all that familiar with what the FBI is required to do in response to a subpoena like this. This just isn't a process that I'm all that familiar with. Is there anything that could be done through this process? Is there anything that Mike Conaway or Devin Nunes could do on your committee to really interfere with the Mueller investigation or to either, I guess, force them to disclose stuff that might impede their ability to prosecute and investigate this, or otherwise screw with what the special counsel is doing?
Well, you know, they certainly could make the department and special counsel's life difficult if they're subpoenaing materials that are part of the investigative work product that the department normally would not share with Congress. And so, yes, it could create real problems. Now, here they've threatened to bring the Attorney General in open session before our committee. Frankly, many of us would welcome that, welcome the chance to question the Attorney General under oath. I have a hard time believing they would actually fall through on that threat, but nonetheless, we would welcome the opportunity to have him testify before the committee. But we don't want to interfere in anything that Bob Mueller is doing, and we made it clear and committed at the outset we would do our best to coordinate so that we wouldn't. This, to me, violates that commitment to the special counsel, and I leave it to my colleagues in the majority to explain why they're doing this, why this confrontation with the Department of Justice, which seems so wholly unwarranted.
Hmm. Congressman Adam Schiff, the top Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee, thank you for joining us on short notice tonight, sir. It's nice to see you.